digital tattoos. Even dead and buried people are detected.
On s'est posé beaucoup de questions et on a constaté qu'au final, les personnes qui étaient injectées étaient tatouées numériquement.
This woman filmed her video in a graveyard, the only place, she says, where there's no electronic signal interference. But according to her, even the dead are emitting Bluetooth signals that, she says, come from tiny Bluetooth microchips that were inserted into them when they got the COVID-19 vaccine.
C'est pas pour vous faire peur, maman. C'est justement pour alerter la population. Regardez.
For months now, lots of videos online have been making the same claim.
The Bluetooth of everyone on the plane who's jabbed.
Some people are even saying that the words Pfizer or AstraZeneca appear in the list of Bluetooth devices they can connect to. That's easily explained. You can change the name of a Bluetooth device to whatever you want just by going in your Bluetooth settings. So they could have just changed the name themselves. But is it even possible to inject Bluetooth capabilities into someone? We contacted Olivier Ezrati, a technology consultant. He told us first of all that Bluetooth technology needs a sensor, a battery, and an antenna to work.
The whole device is at least several millimeters wide and several centimeters long, so there's no way it would fit in the needle of a syringe, which for the COVID vaccine is about 0.5 to 0.8 millimeters in diameter. A Bluetooth chip by itself can't do anything. It has to be linked with other devices in order to be usable, so this doesn't exist. And even if it did, we would have found it before this, because if it was part of every vaccine, someone would have already discovered it. You have to reverse the burden of proof. With a situation like this, we can't prove that something doesn't exist. So if it does exist, someone has to prove it.
So Olivier is skeptical. But can you make Bluetooth technology tiny enough to be inserted into the body? Is there a way of putting microchips into someone?
There is research that involves putting sensors on the human body, but these sensors exist for good reasons. For example, you can have sensors that measure blood sugar for diabetics. They're generally external, with a tiny needle that goes into the skin and which sends information via Bluetooth. But it's not injected by a syringe. It's a system with a sensor that's as big as a coin.
So these videos simply showing a Bluetooth device being detected nearby isn't enough proof that people are being injected with Bluetooth technology through the COVID-19 vaccine. Now, there is research over whether you can make this kind of technology small enough to be inserted into the body. But if there was, it wouldn't be used at all for vaccination, but more to treat specific diseases like diabetes.